know will work in the long term is to make sure our education system is second to none. Every child has the skills they need to compete for the high-wage jobs in the future. I've laid out a comprehensive plan to get there that will give our kids the opportunities they deserve. We're going to invest in early childhood education. We're going to pay our teachers higher salaries and give them more support. Said that this isn't an issue he's been focused on. That's what he said. He said, you haven't been focused on education. Well, let me tell you, if you want to create jobs and grow this economy in the 21st century, you had better have a president who focuses on education. Because we know the countries that out-teach us today will out-compete us tomorrow. So we're going to invest in early childhood education, pay our teachers more, give them more support. We will have the highest standards, but we will not ask teachers to teach simply to a test because we want our kids learning art and music and science, all those things. And I'm going to make a commitment. I'm making a solemn vow to the young people of America, and there are a lot of them here today. Or your community. If you join the military, work in the Peace Corps, if you work in a homeless shelter or a veteran's home, if you serve in a school in need or a hospital that has a shortage of nurses, if in some fashion you decide to invest in your country with your spirit and your energy and your imagination, and I make this promise, we are going to invest in you by making sure that every single one of you can afford to go to college. No ifs, ands, or buts. No ifs, ands, or buts. There's one more thing that we're going to have to do, and that is to modernize our outdated financial regulations. We've got to put in place the common sense rules of the road I've been calling for since March. Rules that will keep our market free and fair and honest. Rules that will restore accountability and responsibility in the boardroom and make sure Wall Street can never get away with the stunts and shenanigans that caused this crisis again. But just as we demand accountability on Wall Street, we have to demand it in Washington. That's why I'm not going to stand here and simply tell you what I'm going to spend. I'm going to tell you how we're going to save when I'm president. I'll do what you do in your own family budgets and make sure we're spending money wisely. I will go through the entire federal budget, page by page, line by line, and eliminate programs that don't work and aren't needed. And we'll start by ending a war in Iraq that is costing us. Responsibility and accountability on Wall Street and in Washington. Common sense regulations to prevent a crisis like this from ever happening again. Investments in the technology and innovation, in science and research and development that will restore prosperity and lead to new jobs and a new economy for the 21st century. Bottom-up growth that gives every American a fair shot at the American dream. Sometimes when I get tired on the campaign trail, I think about the people I've met. I think about the young woman I met who was going to school full-time, but because she had a sister with cerebral palsy, she had to work full-time too. So she'd finish school and then take care of her sister, get to bed about 10. She'd wake up at 1 o'clock and work the night shift at the Federal Express, taking packages out to airplanes. Got 3 hours of sleep a night. You know, she didn't expect government to solve all her problems, but she didn't understand why government couldn't do a little more to make sure, with all the hard work she was putting in, that she got a better chance of living out her American dream. I think about the guy I met who, maybe 55 years old, had been laid off of the place where he had worked for 30 years, had to pack up the equipment that he had worked on all those years and see it shipped off to China. And he tried to explain to me what it was like not just to lose a job, to lose health care, to lose benefits, but what it's like to have to go home and tell your wife that you don't have a job anymore, and tell your kids that things are going to be tough for a while.
The sense of purpose,
the sense of self-worth that he had lost with that job.
I'm going to try and keep the mic very close to my mouth.
I don't like an America where somebody like that who is willing to work can't find work. I don't like to see a situation in which a young person who has big dreams finds those dreams stunted because we're not giving her a helping hand. I won't pretend that this is going to be easy, and that it's going to come without a cost. We're all going to need to sacrifice. We will all need to pull our weight. Because now more than ever, we're all in this together. You know, George Bush, Dick Cheney, John McCain, they all believe that we're in this on our own. If you lose your job, tough luck, you're on your own. You can't afford college, tough luck, figure it out. But what this crisis has taught us is that in the end, there is no real separation between Main Street and Wall Street. There's only the road we're traveling on as Americans. We will rise or fall on that journey as one people, as one nation. This country and the dream it represents are being tested in a way that we haven't seen in nearly a century. And future generations will judge ours by how we respond to this test. Will they say that this was a time when America lost its way, when we lost our nerve, when we lost our purpose? Will they say that this was a time when we allowed our own petty differences and broken politics to plunge this country into a dark and painful recession? Or will they say that this was another one of those moments when America overcame, when we battled back from adversity by recognizing that common stake we have in each other's success? By understanding that I am my brother's keeper and I am my sister's keeper. This is one of my goals. Abington, I realize you're cynical. I realize sometimes everybody's cynical. We're all fed up sometimes with politics. I understand that you're disappointed and even angry with your leaders. You have every right to be. But despite all this, I ask of you what's been asked of the American people in times of trial and turmoil throughout our history. I ask you to believe. I ask you to believe in yourselves, in each other, and in the future we can build together. Together we cannot fail. Not now. Not when we have a crisis to solve and an economy to save. Not when there's so many Americans without jobs, so many losing their homes. Not when their families who can't afford to see a doctor or send their kids to college or pay even the bills at the end of the month. Not when there's a generation that's counting on us to give them the same opportunities, the same chances that we had for ourselves. We can do this. We have done it before. You think about why we're standing here today. It has to do with the fact that previous generations sacrificed and fought in tougher times than these. On our behalf. Well, some of us had grandparents or parents who said, maybe I can't go to college, but if I work hard enough, maybe my child can go to college. Some of us had parents or grandparents who said, maybe I can't own my own business. I'll work on a factory line. I'll do what it takes, and the working conditions may be tough, but if I keep on putting in the effort, and maybe someday my
good
daughter,
morning, Shadella, as you said. Good
she
afternoon. We are a Schwartzman Stadium
here. I may have to rent cold water pipes, but maybe someday my child will have a home
of course, traditionally, that he can call these his areas own. Around the city of Philadelphia. These
I may not have a lot of money.
Trend Republican,
but maybe someday
Republican when
my child
the
will run
comes around. But over the
political
last several
office.
Years, there's been a noticeable change.
I'm not there in a small village. But maybe someday my son will be president of the United States. That's what the American dream's about. That's what we're fighting for. That's what's at stake in this election. And if all of you are willing to work with me and fight with me, if you want to organize and get on the phone and knock on doors, talk to your friends, talk to your neighbors, register to vote, turn out on November 4th, I promise you this, you will not just win Pennsylvania. We will win this general election, and you and I together will bring this country to change.